A list by the Agrarian Reform Department reaffirms the Tinang farmers as the rightful owners of the disputed land in Tarlac. A special task force revalidated the list of farmer beneficiaries, which includes a group from Tinang, some of whom were among those arrested earlier this month. Nakilusang Magbubukid ng Pilipinas says the list bolsters the rightful claim of the Tinang farmers to the 200-hectare land. The group also called charges against the farmers' baseless. The so-called Tinang 83 were arrested and charged with malicious mischief and illegal assembly for a tilling activity at the disputed land on June 9th. Complaints by Concepcion Mayor-elect Noel Villanueva and a cooperative prompted their arrest. They were freed on June 12th after posting bail. Philippine President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will temporarily head the Agriculture Department once he assumes office on June 30. That's as he believes personally handling the agency will help expedite programs for the agriculture sector.
I think that the problem is severe enough that I have decided to take on the portfolio of Secretary of Agriculture, at least for now. And at least until we can reorganize the Department of Agriculture in the way that it will make it ready for the next years to come. Marami tayong mga kailangang palitan. We're going back to basics and trying, and we will rebuild the value chain of agriculture. And that is why I thought it's important that the president take that portfolio, so that not only to make it clear to everyone what a high priority we put on the agricultural sector.
Marcos's priorities as DA chief include raising funding for the agriculture sector, boosting production and modernization by acquiring more post-harvest facilities.
Now that we are in a situation where we very much have to boost production and we very much have to support the farmers, maybe we can look at that. Pag nakikita man natin yung accounting doon sa rice tarification, yung 10 billion na yun, kuminsan meron pang unspent. So pwede pang gamitin yun.
Marcos earlier said food security was going to be a priority of his administration during the campaign period. The incoming president even said he believed rice prices can be brought down to 20 pesos per kilo. Now his team is projecting an increase in food prices because of external factors affecting the price of wheat.
News: the president-elect Marcos heading the Agriculture Department gets mixed reactions. The Samahang Industriya ng Agrikultura, o SINAG, is optimistic Marcos can rid the agency of corruption. SINAG is composed of seed growers, irrigators, fisheries, livestock groups, and rice farmers. Sapang Bagnoy farmers also welcoming them. They expressed hope that with Marcos heading the department, their sector will get a bigger share of the budget.
Good news, no? Kasi grabe ang corruption sa DA. From seeds up to import, puro corruption. Yung production cost talaga mataas, alam din yan. And ang inaano niya, kung ma-normalize siguro yung presyo, pwedeng bumaba. Ang target siguro by next year, August, kung kayang ibaba na 27 to 28 pesos, malaking bagay na yun.
Welcome na welcome po yan, sir. Kasi nakikita po namin kasi pagka panahon po ng budget hearing ng DA, parang nakukuwan po yung mga officialis ng DA. Baka ngayon pagka si BBM po yung nakaupo doon, baka marinig po natin dyan, puro your excellency, your budget is approved.
But not everyone is happy about Marcos assuming the post of Agriculture Secretary. The Kilusang Magbubukid ng Pilipinas believes Marcos is grossly unqualified to tackle the country's looming food crisis, adding he has no track record in agriculture to stand upon. It also points out that in his many years as a legislator, Marcos has not authored or co-authored any law beneficial to farmers. KMP also accuses Marcos of being power-hungry, noting that the Agriculture Department is a central destination of foreign loans and investments from the World Bank and other financial institutions.